हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू BEHS सुमति अकेडमी। सो वी आर लर्निंग द चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर 3, फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज फाइबर। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव टू लर्न व्हाट इज यार्न। ओके, मीन्स इफ यू विल सी द एक्टिविटी 1, सो इन दिस एक्टिविटी अ वूलन स्ट्रिंग इज टेकन। ओके, सो वेन एवर यू ट्विस्ट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ दिस वूलन, यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दैट each strand is made up of bunch of fiber. Whenever you just twist in opposite side the strand, so you just see that each strand is made up of bunch of fibers. So that means this bunch of fiber is nothing, it is a yarn. So what is yarn? If we will talk about the fibers, so fibers are very thin and short in length. Okay, then now it is not possible to form a fabric with very thin and short length component. So what we have done, that we just make a bunch of fiber. Then we pressed and it is twisted. So this is then after the pressing or after the twisting, a bunch of fibers, it will convert into a long strands, okay, or long thread. So this long and strong thread is called as yarn. Okay, so what is yarn? A bunch of the fiber which is pressed and twisted and then converted into a long and strong thread, that bunch of fiber is called as yarn. Okay, now next activity we have, that if we will take a cotton wool, so what we see, when we pulled apart the cotton wool, so what we see that we can see easily the yarn. Okay, because if we twist or if we pulled out the cotton wool, so we will see so many small and thin threads like a structure. Okay, so again it is clear what is a yarn. Yarn is a bunch of fiber which is pressed and twisted to make a long and strong thread. So with the help of yarn we make the fiber. Now if we will talk, the process of twisting fiber to make yarn is called spinning. What is spinning? It is a most important process to make a yarn. Whenever we the process of twisting fibers, okay, you can also see the cotton. When we twist the cotton, it will form as a long thread. That means with the cotton we are making a long thread or we are making a yarn. At home you can do this activity. When you pulled out the cotton and you just twist the cotton and pull the cotton, then you will find out that it is forming in a thread. So this process is called spinning. Now spinning can be done by using simple tools like hand spindle or spinning charkha. Okay, we have Mahatma Gandhi was also used this charkha. So charkha, or that is also called takli in a local language. So this is used, this is a hand spindle. It is a hand process for twisting the fiber to make the yarn. Now if we will talk about on a large scale, spinning is done by the modern spinning machines which produce stronger yarn of uniform thickness. Now we are living in the 21st century, so we have so many modern machines, so through which we can get the very strong yarn or uniform thickness. Okay, so we have learned what is fiber and what is yarn. Now we have to learn about how we can convert yarn to fabric. Okay, yarn to fabric. So now we have how we converted yarn to fabric. So there are basic we have the two procedure, that is weaving and knitting. So with the help of weaving and knitting we can convert yarn to fabric. So this process, you have to read the activity 3. So if we will talk about the weaving, so what happened, the weaving, it is a arrangement on a device of yarns with the it is arrangement of a yarns on a device manually with the help of a needle. So by which this weaving is done on a device which is called looms. Okay, and small looms which can be operated manually are called as a hand looms, or the looms which cannot be operated manually. If we have to produce on a large scale, so we use the machines, we use the mills, then it is called power looms. Okay, so it is a process or it is arrangement, weaving is arrangement by which with the help of looms and the needles we can convert yarn to fabric. Now next is knitting. So we all have seen knitting around us. We have seen how wool is knitted into a sweater, so it is very useful. Okay, we can easily convert a bunch of yarn into fiber with the help of two needle, long needles. So this process is called as knitting. On with the help of knitting, we can also convert the yarn into the fabric or directly into the t-shirts, muffler, waist, sweaters, etc. Okay, so that means knitting can, it can be knitting also can be done by the hands or long knitted needles or the machines. Knitting also can be done by the both, by manually and the machine. So that means there is a chain, means proteins chains will convert into a fiber, fiber will convert into the yarn, yarn will convert into the fabric, and fabric is will be converted to the cloth, which will be the finished product. So okay, so today you have to complete, or you have to practice activity 1, activity 2 and at your home. Okay, till thank you, and stay safe at your home.